So I welcome you for this 5 days face-to-face FDP on virtual and augmented reality. This faculty development program is sponsored by AICT Training and Learning, that is the Atal Academy. So myself, Dr. Deepak Shirbhate, I'm working as a principal in Vikramshila Polytechnic, Darapur, Taluka Dariyapur, District Amravati, Maharashtra, State of India. So our today's session will be VRML proximity sensor used for controlling the spinning of wheel. So you can see that one wheel is spinning, and if I enter into the proximity of this wheel, then it will start spinning and it will rotate by 360 degrees. So the only thing is that my presence must be detected nearby the wheel, and it will start spinning, it will start rotating, and it will complete one rotation and it will come to halt. So this is what I want to create. So a simple program, VRML program or coding is required for this. There will be one proximity sensor, there will be one time sensor, and there will be one route. That's all. So this is what we are expected to create. So we will open the Scratch file. Now it is not having any kind of logic. In the end, I will tell you how to create the Scratch file. So create the group and bring the index first under the group. And then in the interaction, you go to the proximity sensor, bring that proximity sensor to absolute 000. First of all, bring it below index faceset, and then actually I want to set up the sensor attributes. So it will be 30 meters, because here the unit is 30. So it means it is 30 meters, because in VRML it is 30 meters. Okay, so it is 30 meters by 30 meters by 30 meters, that is the proximity. Okay, so I have set up this box. Actually you can see the box. So as soon as I will enter inside this box, the sensor will get activated, and then there will be some action. So then we will introduce a time sensor. I have actually brought the time sensor to absolute zero, that is absolute zero coordinate, 000, and I am applying this time sensor to the entire group, which is containing the index faceset as well as proximity sensor. The time period should be, I think, 4 or 2 seconds will be good enough. Okay, but first of all we will add the node. Okay, so we will actually add the node. So I want that entire group should rotate. So go to the timeline, then drag this timer key to 2.5 and rotate by 90 degree. Then drag the key to 0.5 and rotate by 180 degree. Then 2.5 and 360 degree, 270 degree, I think. And at the end of 10 second, it is 360 degree. I have taken a period of say 10 second. Okay, so you can reduce the period 4 second or 2 second, so it will actually affect the speed. Then there will be route creation. Just create the route. So route will be from the proximity sensor to the time sensor, and I want inter time SF time, and here I want set start time SF time. Okay, so that completes, and here you will get the green flag. It means that the logic is correct. Now just check everything. It seems that everything is correct. Now you just save the files or save as the file before you export it to VRML. Now give a appropriate name, say proximity sensor dot proximity sensor will. This is the Vivetti file, and now we will create uncompressed VRML file. So that completes the exporting, and now we will check the file. And you can see that it is working, the proximity sensor is working. So it will detect your presence, and then it will actually start the animation. That is what proximity sensor means. So this is a VRML sensor, and it will bring interactivity to the virtual world actually. So you can examine, you just go away, you walk away, and then you try to enter slowly and see, as soon as you enter the box of 30 by 30 by 30 meters, the sensor should work and it should start spinning the wheel, and the wheel should stop because it is not in loop, so it will stop. Now your digital presence actually can be shown here by avatar. So you just click view my avatar, and this is your digital presence, and now you are represented digitally in the virtual world. And as soon as your presence will be detected by the proximity sensor, so it will start spinning the wheel. So it is just like, say, what we call it as eye cursor, eye blinking cursor in the world document. Actually, eye blinking cursor is your presence in the world document. When you say that, when you type something, it will start from the eye blinking cursor. So that is your presence in the world document. Or mouse cursor is the presence of your is your presence in the Word document. Likewise, in the VRML, in the VRML world, your presence is actually represented by the avatar. So it is actually you are in the form of avatar. Most times actually it will hide the view. So that's why many people do not prefer to make the avatar on. Now, how to create the scratch file? Actually, suppose you want to create a scratch file for the programming, you just open the Vivetti file. Second one is the VRML file. So you open the Vivetti file, and you can, if you expand this file, you will see that there are a lot of logic. So you remove all the logic. You remove the root, you remove the time sensor, you remove the proximity sensor, and now it has become a scratch file. Now you just save this file, and then you can start practicing the programming. So this is how we can create a scratch file. It is very simple. You just remove every logic except the index facet, because that is the actual object. If you remove that, then there will be nothing. So it is represented in red. So just keep all the index facet and you can remove rest of the logic. And many times it will give some warning, dependency warning. So you ignore the warning and you remove it. So in this way you can create a scratch file. So this will help you in programming. So in the practical session, you can actually change the time interval. You can make the spinning fast or slow. Then you can increase the proximity sensor area by 20 by 20 by 20 or 10 by 10 by 10 or 40 by 40 by 40. So in this way, you try on your own. You change the parameters and you test it whether the parameters are working properly or not. And if you have any questions, you can definitely ask me. Thank you. Thank you.